Okay, once again, this is Courtney. I'm going to start this segment off with a short musical interlude. I'm going to just lighten the mood a little bit, just give everybody a couple minutes to relax, regroup, and if you have any questions going forward, just get them prepared, okay?
All right.
I'm just going to play a little song for you guys. Let me know if you can hear. Today, I was going to start my, wait a minute. Can everybody hear me? Okay. I just want to make sure you guys can hear me. Okay, I'm going to start my presentation today, picking up from where we left off on last week. Last week, we were talking about the origin of the word queen, and I did my research and found out the origin of that word, and I decided to make a change to the title of the book that I was writing and also the title of this workshop. So I decided to go with empowering the Empress Within as the title for the workshop. And I'm gonna be just going with that. So picking up from last week, I'm just gonna go over the definition, because I know Mansa, you asked last week the difference between goddess and empress and how to use that when addressing someone, addressing a young lady or female. So I found out that the Empress is a woman ruler, a great power over an empire. Empresses rule over empires. The difference between that and a queen rules over a kingdom, and a queen is more like a monarch, where empress is just a sovereign power. Okay. I also found out that the empress represents the mother and the creator, and it also indicates feminine power and feminine energy. Now, a goddess, on the other hand, has two different meanings for the same word. So the first definition is a female deity, and that definition mostly goes with the female that they mostly use in Greek mythology and ancient Egyptian history, and that names different female deities. The second definition of a goddess is for the human or the female in flesh on earth, and that is a woman who is adored especially for her beauty. So when you use that word in reference to a female, a living female on earth, it's just in reference to giving her beauty, or her beauty, or you respecting her feminine qualities. Okay. So I did some research, and there's several different goddesses in ancient Egyptian history. One that I'm going to speak on today is Ma'at, and there are seven principles that I really appreciate about the goddess Ma'at. Now, Ma'at was an ancient Egyptian, the personification of truth, justice, and cosmic order. Okay, so she has to do with order and justice. The seven principles of Ma'at, they are truth, justice, harmony, balance, order, reciprocity, and propriety. Okay, so the first principle of truth has to deal with the ability to understand the difference between the real and the unreal. So, for example, we're all spiritual beings here on earth having a human experience. And these experiences that we have are what is creating our reality. So you have to understand that basic principle about truth. And once you get into that, it goes deeper, because like I said last week, thoughts become things. And once we learn how to tap into our inner being and our inner powers, we can use those to create a better reality for ourselves. And that's what we're trying to do right now. We're learning. We're coming together as a family. We're taking time out to do our research and study. And all of that is going to reshape our family, make it stronger. And like Mansa was just saying, build a strong foundation that can't be broken. So if we are accepting that truth in our reality right now, then we're helping to reshape and remold how the reality is going to be going into the future, going forward. Okay, justice is the state in which there is equity for all persons, for all creatures, and for the planet on which all of these rely for life. Justice is not, this is not talking about equality. Equity is more of an asset than trying to be equal. Equity is more so you're trying to make sure that everybody has the same ground to stand on. Nobody is coming in at a disadvantage. And that goes for every being on the face of the planet. Because you can see how when mankind does things to the environment, how it affects the creatures, how it affects nature, how it affects the planet as a whole, because the planet itself is a living organism. So all of that just goes to show you how everything ties together. And just like Atun Ray talks about, it's a part of the all. You can't take away anything from it or add anything to it. So that goes in line with that. The next one is harmony. And harmony is the state of being in which different expressions of God's spirit that includes human beings, animals, plants, etc., move together in ways that create alignment and beauty. So harmony just means that everything is flowing naturally. Nothing is blocking or obstructing anything. Harmony has to deal with everything flowing and in balance. And that's the next one, balance. Balance is a state of homeostasis in which the internal and external environments of an individual or group are aligned with God, one another, and the rest of creation. It is the experience of existing in the place where opposites meet, the creation point, where new life is generated and new possibilities come into being. So that's what balance is for. You need balance in everything. I talk about that all the time. That's why I enjoy bringing female energy to the platform, because we need a balance. We need that that masculine and feminine energy, and that goes for everything. You need that throughout everything in life. Order is a state of being in which things occupy the place and space in which they were created. They are arranged in ways that are uncluttered, free of access, and clear. So order just means that, I say this all the time, get your house in order, or I'm getting my house in order. That means you have to have everything in its place where it belongs. You can't have order out of chaos, or you can't think clearly when your space is cluttered, or, you know, when you have things that you need to clean up in your house or anything. That goes with anything. Even if you're riding through a neighborhood and you see a bunch of nice houses, but then you see one house that just stuff all in the yard and, you know, it's just out of order. It's off. It throws everything off. There's no balance in that. So that's the principle of order. Reciprocity is the reality that what comes around goes around, as above, so below. It's the same karma. And there's a motion and a rhythm of cause and effect, give and take, forward and backward to every aspect of creation. And that's basically just self-explanatory for reciprocity. And the last one is propriety. I hope I'm saying that right, propriety. And that means to be and to do what is right, according to the truth that all human beings are spiritual beings. Right means to live out those behaviors, words, actions, thoughts, and feelings which do not harm another being, creature, or aspect of creation, being with self. So that right there is just speaking of just trying to incorporate basically all of these laws into one, being in balance and harmony with nature, with every other being and creature, even the planet itself. Reciprocity, that's kind of like do unto others as they do unto you. And that's something that I noticed with a lot of ancient Egyptian history. A lot of the Bible teachings that we learn in religion, all of those are based off of things that came out of the pyramid walls. And they basically turned a lot of stuff around and flipped it around, making it into religion instead of saying that it's the principles of Ma'at. So I think that these principles are very, they're all very good for us to just go over every now and then and review, and just to weigh ourselves, because I believe Ma'at was the one that weighs your heart against the weight of a feather. And I think that if we self-examine ourselves every now and then against these principles to make sure that we are aligned in what we're supposed to do individually, I think it'll make a very big impact on our personal growth. And that's all I have for today. Any questions, comments?
Cool. I just wanted to say this. One of the things that the Master Teacher used to break the spell was, because you had touched on it a little bit, was to know the English language, know the etymology of the English language or words that we use. Okay, I thought you were going to go in a direction that when you use the word queen and empress, okay, because if you get a collegiate dictionary, the word queen translates or is defined as a harlot, a streetwalker, a prostitute. You know, you wouldn't want, I wouldn't want to be calling my woman my queen, because the early English of that word, that's what it meant. So the Queen of England is known as the harlot, according to what is written in the New Testament. You know, they use the word harlot, explaining her stature or stature. You know what I'm saying? So one of the things that he used to break the spell was to have a knowledge of the English language, and not to use derogatory terms and not knowing what they meant. So one of the things that I used to do was, I got a collegiate dictionary. I don't have one now. I need to go and get one. Was to look those words up and look at the early English and find out what these words actually mean, because the definition didn't change from when they first instituted these words. And we still throw them around like it's some term of endearment or it means something great, because we're using English. And the English and the original language are two different things. You know, when you translate from one language to another, you lose something. You use the definite meaning, like the word God and El. It takes away from calling the Most High God, okay? Because God defines human attributes. So so we can't refer to him as God, because you're bringing him down to our level, according to what the master teacher told us. Now, I don't know if you're using those same terminologies now, you know, but I'm old school, and that's what I was taught then. I don't know if it's just a change or what, but I'm still going to use those principles, because, you know, I saw them myself. I used my own eyes to look these things up myself. You know, words like could, should, would, where, here, you know what I'm saying? Those words are obsolete. They're not used in the original language, you know what I'm saying? So, you know, we that's why he was, the master teacher was trying to push us to use Nubic or ancient language, because it was more defined in describing a sentence of what you were saying, because it was definitive as to what you were talking about. You knew what you were saying, because it didn't give you two meanings. Like the word know, K-N-O-W, and N-O. You see, your brain can't tell the difference between the two, you know, but we know the difference because that's the way we want to perceive it. You know, perception is the key to everything. So when we're using these words, you know, we're actually demeaning ourselves by using those terminologies that the meaning of it didn't change when they first used that language, and that's their language. That's not our language, you know. So we have to. We were taught that this is what we have to do in order to not use those types of words, like the word believe and belief. I don't use those kinds of words. You know, either I know something or I don't. You know what I'm saying? That's the way I use. That's the way I'll speak in a sentence or a conversation. I don't use those words, can't, stuff like that, because you're limiting yourself. You see. So you have to be more definitive when you use these words. You have to always constantly think of when you're speaking, you know, using words like that, you're limiting yourself and the people that you're talking to, because this is what they're going to perceive, because this is what they were influenced by all their lives. Now, the master teacher was, you know, very instrumental in my life, because this is what he taught me. I'm just passing that on to you all. I hope
I
didn't,
I appreciate that, because actually, we missed you last week, because that's exactly the topic of discussion that we